Have you ever felt that getting onto a job with a desired package is one of the toughest tasks is in today's changing time? Or you must be thinking that I have spent one third of my life educating myself just to get a two-page resume and call myself a fresher? I found that there is a basic flaw in the decision of career choices that we do in India. In India, the traditional career choices are done something like this. If a student in his 10th standard gets 70% and above, he takes science. If he scores between 60 to 70, he opts for commerce. And if he scores below 60, he goes for arts. We are hardwired to take decisions based on parental, societal, and peer pressure. In India, hobbies are not converted into passion and that into a profession. No. Hobbies are a vacation, time pass activities. World Bank research says that the proportionate of job or automation can be done in India up to 69% of the jobs. We see that every year, the percentage of students who are graduating, every year, the employability of those students is reducing year by year. And on the other hand, we observe that the average age of an Indian is 29. 65% of our country's population is below the age of 35. Guys and girls, we are sitting on the landmine of human potential. And if this potential is not channelized, we will have bad and worse situations in near future. I want to share three instances from my own life which will help you to understand how can we become more employable going forward. I remember there were multiple occasions in my life when I had butterflies in my stomach. And as a student, when we go for exams, when we go to make career choices, and maybe it is for going to check the results. I remember it was 1st of May 1998. I was in 7th grade. And I was going with my uncle to check the results of 7th grade. The distance between my school and my home was approximately 15 minutes on his kinetic. We started from our home and we took four different halts. And it was on my request. I asked him, please wait on these stops. And all these four halts were to pray that I get cleared in this 7th grade examination. And while we were going to school, I saw a lot of friends of mine studying with me, my classmates, waving at me when they were coming back. Which means what? That they cleared their examination. And that increased the pressure within me. In next few minutes, I was standing in classroom, in front of my class teacher. And I was excited, nervous, to know what the outcome is. And she said, Jogesh, wait, I will call you. And that was in a little stern voice. I looked at my uncle and he was now equally tensed. After a few minutes, she called me and said, I'm really sorry. Jogesh, you have failed. The sound of Jogesh, you have failed is still very live and active within me. As if I did not fail in 7th grade, but I failed in life. While I was coming back, I was thinking, how will I face my friends? I was thinking, how will I look at neighbors? What questions will they ask? Why? Because normally, friends, even though they know the result, they will ask you. And recently, I was studying about a research which was conducted in US. And it was talking about what is the most common disease, which is danger, then cancer, danger, then AIDS, danger, then malaria. And it is called as LKK. And everyone in this room sitting right now is suffering from that disease. that this is log kya kahenge. And in those days, when I failed with that result, while I was coming back, I had a lot of chattering in my mind from around people. And they were all saying that, Jogesh, you will do nothing in life. Jogesh, this might happen. Jogesh, that might happen. But boys and girls and my dear friends, there was also one chattering which was happening within me, which was telling me, Jogesh, do not continue in this vernacular medium. Go to English medium school. And I said to my parents that this is what I want to do. They looked at me and said, you are in Hindi medium. You could not clear that. And you want to go to English medium school? Time passed. I got admission to English medium school. But I want to ask you one question. What do I call this small voice that was within me telling me to take admission to English medium school? Where did that small voice come from? Why is it so important to listen to that small voice? Time passed, and now was the time for me to decide what do I want to do after my 10 plus 2. Do I want to stay back in my hometown, Burhanpur, Madhya Pradesh? Or should I go out and chase my dreams for further studies? And the child within me said, do not go anywhere, stay in your hometown, enjoy with your school friends. But that day, I was standing with my dad on my railway station, deciding, should I take the ticket to Mumbai or stay back and enjoy the vacations with my relatives? Friends, for the second time in my life, there was a lot of suggestions as usual. And within those suggestions, there was this small voice which was telling me, Jogesh, go to the city of dreams because there's something bigger, something better which is in front of you. I listened to my small voice. I got admission in Mumbai, one of the colleges. I did my graduation, I'm a commerce graduate. And I got campus placement. Company named TCS, all of us are familiar with, they hired me. In December 2006, I got selected campus placement. In 1997, we had something tragical thing happen in our family. We lost 4 crore rupees in our genius factory. And from 97 to 2006, 2007, the time was most difficult time that we've seen. And the day I got offer letter from TCS, I was very happy. Normally, in 2006, there was no cell phone. So I went to a STD booth to call my parents and tell them that, you know what? I have made them proud, according to me. And I called. I was very happy. I called them and I shared that, you know what? I got TCS offer. What is the package? The next question. 1,63,000 in those times, it was a big amount at that time. And in a package of 1,63,000. And for a moment, guys, I felt everything now is going to change. The loans that I had taken for my studies and the struggle that we have normally on month ends are now going to get ended. And 2nd July was my first day in TCS 2007. I remember training room, I remember friends there, I remember what I learned. But I was on a single, every single day, wanting to calculate ki net kitna aega, what will be the net amount that will get credited to my account. Why? Excited. And it was a big validation for me to get my first salary. 31st July, normally companies like TCS pay their salary on the last working day. 31st July, it was the salary day. Morning, I checked message, no message. 8 a.m., I checked message, no message. Normally there is a message that you get, and that's what my senior told me. I said, okay. 9 a.m., no message. I called my friends, did you get any message? No. 10 a.m., there was this message beep of Nokia phone that we used to have that time. I opened the message. Your account is credited with 9,100 rupees. Wow! big validation. Why? 3 years I studied in Mumbai, stayed in hostel, everything sponsored by my relatives. For me, it was big validation. I thought to give surprise to my parents, to my family back in hometown. On the next Friday, I took the train. I took the train and I went to my hometown. As soon as I put that on your birthplace, you put your first leg, oh, it was different that day. I took auto, went to home, I knocked the door, my mom opens up the door. And she is happy, but also a little fearful. Why? Because it's first one, have you taken leaves? No, I have not taken leaves, it's a weekend. I have something to share with you. What is it? I said, come. My dad and my mom, both of them sitting on the hall. Listen to me very carefully, guys. Sitting in the hall. I said, what is it? Why have you come here? Took out an envelope from my pocket and I handed over that envelope with 9,100 rupees to my parents. He took the envelope, he opened it. It was 9,100 rupees. That was the moment when they put both their hands on my head and said, God bless you. Almost 9 years, we did not see 9,100 rupees together. That is the day I decided that it is my life's mission to make the country employable. Why? Because in every home, that fresher who is wanting to get a job just to pay off the loans that he has taken, it is not only his mission, but it is equally mine. I have worked for over a decade with companies like TCS and JP Morgan. And then something happened on 23rd of November 2016 when I decided to quit my corporate life and work on this mission. Again, there was a lot of chattering which was happening around me. My parents opposed, my family opposed, my wife supported. And a lot of bosses that I worked with, all of them said, Jogesh, don't get into that. It's a different world altogether. You will not be able to manage. And within those chattering boys and girls, there was this little voice, which for the third time in my life, was wanting to tell me that, Jogesh, quit this job and work on what you're passionate about. And help every individual Jogesh who is wanting to find that job, wanting to become more employable, don't know how to design resume, don't know how to speak in the interview, and help them to be more employable. That is the day I quit my job. And I started on this mission. Journey was not easy, but I am very proud to say that in last couple of years, we have been able to train lakhs and lakhs of students via social media, via online training and in-person workshops. But the point I'm trying to make here today is, if all of you are wanting to be more employable, it does not necessarily mean that you want to really get onto a job. No. It can also necessarily mean, as sir said, it's about also creating some jobs. And for that, I want to talk about what was that little voice which was wanting to communicate with me throughout this journey? Three instances I shared. What was that little voice which was wanting to communicate with me? How do I determine that and believe on that voice rather than suppressing it? All of us have some hobby. We like it, but we are told from childhood that, you know what, it is only a time pass activity. And you do not take it to next level. Let me tell you, there's a village in Japan called as Ogimi on Okinawa Island. And this little voice, someone might call it passion, someone might call it inner calling, someone might call it intuition, instinct, you might call it anything, but Japanese call it IKIGAI, I-K-I-G-A-I. And there are four primary elements to IKIGAI. Four primary elements, four pillars. First one is, what is your passion? We see a lot of jobs going out, but the only thing that robot cannot do is your own creativity, and that is going to stay with you. What are you passionate about? How do you identify your passion? Try to list all the hobbies that you have, all of them, and try to see, what can I make passion a profession? Can I make this passion a profession? And as I said, that village, Ogimi, on Okinawa Island, the average age of that people residing in that village on that island is 110 years. 110 years is the life expectancy there, not average age, life expectancy on there. Why? Because people on that island, in that village, have identified their ikigai. The first element in ikigai is, what are you passionate about? What are you passionate about? Can you convert your passion into a profession? And can you make this profession a mission of your life? You can begin. You can say that, Jogesh, I have loans to pay, education loan I have taken. But you build parallelly on it along with a job. It's completely okay. What is your passion? Can you identify your passion? Can you make your passion a profession? Can you make your passion a profession? And are people ready to pay for it? Which means, is there an element of vocation to it? And last but not the least, do you have a vision and a mission to that world? Why? Because if there's no vision, there's no mission, probably the journey becomes fearless. You have to have the driving force which comes only with the mission. And employability for me is the mission that I live with. Last couple of years, I have trained hundreds of them, help them to get onto their job or probably identify their passion. And I believe that each of us, once we try and connect with our core of who you are, is the only time when you start connecting with a lot of things outside. But the problem today is, we are not connected with core of us, who you are. So if together as a nation we want to be more employable, the only thing that you should do is listen to that little voice which normally we will suppress. And that suppression happens at multiple levels. Probably you shut your brain off when someone is talking to you about something. Probably you are driven by what others are doing. And as I said, societal, family, and peer pressure is one of the driving forces that we have. So boys and girls, and my dear friends, if you are wanting to be more employable, get onto a job, or probably get onto an enterprising journey for yourself, start listening to your own inner voice that all of us gets every single day, but what we do is we suppress them. Thank you so much for listening, and have a great day.